Hey everyone, it's Pastor Brittany here. I just wanted to say welcome and we're glad you joined us tonight. Super exciting news. We are going to be starting services back in person on Sunday mornings next week. So I wanted to kind of remind you of that. Pay attention for the announcement video on that. And we're still going to do our challenge for the week. So you still have till Friday afternoon at 7 p.m. to put in your video, to memorize your power verse and send me your video. But this week we're gonna do a box of Tiff's treats. So you'll get a box of cookies, whoever wins that drawing. So make sure that you put your videos in this time and then you'll get them on Sunday when we start back in person. So get those in for me. We're gonna go over the video, over the power verse together. Ready? 1, 2, 3. And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid. And that's found in John 14, verse 27. All right, guys, let's bow our heads and close our eyes, and we're going to open in prayer, and then we're going to go into worship. Father God, I thank you for this time that we have together to come and to worship your name and to glorify you and to learn about your word and about the peace that you bring. And so, Father God, I pray tonight that you would show us what your peace looks like, that you would bring peace into the hearts of each one watching. We thank you for what you're doing. We thank you for your goodness. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, guys, get ready for worship.
I was found in chains of sin, captive to the hopelessness. I heard you calling out, drowning the voice of doubt. Weary from my wandering, taking me, but your love has overcome. His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. Lord, turn His face toward you and give you peace. The Lord bless you and keep you. Make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. Lord, turn His face toward you and give you peace. Amen. 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 His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. Lord, turn His face toward you and give you peace. We receive. Amen.
Favor be upon you and a thousand generation, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May His favor be upon you and a thousand generation, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May His favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May His favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May His presence go before you and behind you and beside you. All around you and within you, He is with you, He is with you. In the morning, in the evening, and you're coming, and you're going, and you're weeping and rejoicing. He is for you, 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 He is for you. He is for you.
So as you can easily see, the denumerability of irrational numbers is the equivalent to finding the insolvability of higher degree equations.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Yes?
Can I have a hall pass? I really have to go tinkle.
Really? You don't need a hall pass. This is college. You just get up and go.
Oh, well in that case, I'm out.
Well, I guess that's a good note to end on. See you next class. That's all for today.
Oh, this has been such a stressful day. I don't see how it could get any worse. Oh, check it out. That must be him. My holographic instant messaging. Someone's trying to get in touch with me. Let's see who it is.
Dr. Jones!
T.S.? Is that you? Why are you tied up in a chair?
I've been kidnapped, Dr. Jones.
Kidnapped? Oh my! Well, what can I do to save you?
I need you to bring three things for me within 24 hours.
Sure will. What three things?
I need a snow cone that is raspberry, strawberry, and bubblegum flavor.
Okay.
Also, bring a large pizza.
What kind? Pepperoni?
No, it needs to have gummy bears and sweet tarts on it.
Gummy bears and sweet tarts on a pizza?
Yes, Dr. Jones, the final thing you must bring is a VHS tape of the Disney classic, The Lion King.
A VHS tape? You mean like the huge things I used to play movies on in the 80s?
Yes, all three of these things must be brought to my house within 24 hours if I'm ever going to be released from my kidnapper.
Don't worry, T.S. I won't let you down. Whew, I better get to it. Arizona Jones to the rescue!
Can I help you?
Yes, I'd like a snow cone, please.
Well, good, because that's what we sell here. What flavor?
I would like strawberry, raspberry, and bubblegum flavor, please.
Well, somebody has a sweet tooth.
Just get it for me, will you? My friend's life is on the line.
Excuse me. That'll be $2.
I'm coming for you, T.S.
Welcome to our garage sales. Romulus and Remus, how many times do I have to tell you not to play with that cat? It has the ringworms. I'm sorry, what can we get for you today?
I was hoping to find a VHS tape of The Lion King. Do you have it?
I sure do. I just love this movie.
Okay, so how much do you want for the movie?
I don't know. This movie meant a lot to my boys, Romulus and Remus. Let's just say $20 even.
What? This is a garage sale. Things are supposed to be cheap. I could buy a new one for that.
You're not gonna find a new one on VHS. Besides, I can't sell it cheap. Too many memories of my boys dancing around and singing Hakuna Matata, what a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata ain't no passing craze. It means no worries.
I have lots of worries, lady. My best friend and partner has been kidnapped. I only have a few hours to get to him with a snow cone, a candy pizza, and a VHS tape of The Lion King. I'm freaking out. So give me that movie.
Pleasure doing business with ya.
Oh, T.S. Oh, T.S., I'm so glad to see you. And I made it with just a minute to spare. I got the snow cone, or what's left of the snow cone that didn't melt anyway, and the candy pizza and the Lion King on VHS.
Oh, that's wonderful, Dr. Jones. You can send it there by the TV.
Over here by the TV? You said that so calmly. I mean, why are you not freaking out? You've been kidnapped. I'm freaking out.
No, I'm not freaking out. I'm actually full of peace.
Peace? Are you kidding me?
Well, Dr. Jones, don't you know that even though I'm here tied up, but God is here with me also. I don't have to be afraid or trouble. I can have peace.
Oh, yeah. I hadn't remembered that.
So that's what the kids are learning today. They're learning how no matter what they are going through, they can have peace.
Yeah, I should have remembered that. Jesus came on a mission to give us peace. I guess you have that peace even while being kidnapped.
Haha, literally, kidnapped.
Well, what do you mean?
Well, that's my kidnapper right over there.
Well, did you give him a snow cone?
What? You were kidnapped? By a kid?
Well, he's my nephew. I've been babysitting him and he decided to tie me up and play a game.
So I went through all of this for a game?
Yes. Wanna play?
I'll pass. Well, I've definitely learned a great lesson today. And you're going to learn a great lesson as well. You're going to learn all about how Jesus came to bring peace to someone who was in a terrible situation. Until next time, I'm Arizona Jones.
And I'm Toast Kitty.
And we'll see you next time we go on a mission.
Bye-bye now.
Well, if it isn't Maple Sawback.
Of course it's me. Why wouldn't it be me?
That's what I said.
No, you said isn't Maple Sawback. Oh, wait. If it isn't me, then who is it? Who is it? Oh my gosh. Who am I? Who? For the love of buttermilk biscuits, tell me!
You're Maple Sawback.
I do that. Stay there. What say we get this churching over with and get down to some grub, shall we?
Maple, I'm sorry you're hungry, but you're going to have to wait. We need to have church, and you can eat later.
Oh, no. Don't you start using your fancy folk, city folk words on me like that with all your nouns and verbs and gobbledygook. I'm here because the whole point of today's lesson is food.
Maple, you're mistaken.
See? Steak! Steak! What'd I tell you? You can't fool a lumberjane, although I've never tried steak on a pizza before.
Pizza? I haven't said anything about a steak, let alone a pizza.
Oh, yes you have. I've got the eyes of a weasel and the ears of a rooster. I keep them under my pillow at night. But that's beside the point. I heard you just plain as day talking about how Jesus is gonna give us pizza.
Pizza? Oh, wow. No, Maple. What I actually said was Jesus will give us peace.
Pizza! It's gonna rain down pizza from the sky. Giant pizza pies getting flung down through the air like heavenly Italian UFOs. There's gonna be pepperoni, Canadian bacon, and pineapple, and ooh, my favorite, mayonnaise, cream corn, buckwheat, and trout.
Oh, yuck, that's disgusting.
Oh, try some, city slicker. It'll put hair on your toes, like me, see? Keep some warm.
No, that's even worse. Maple, you've got to listen to me. I said nothing about Jesus giving us pizza. What I did say that Jesus wants to give us peace.
Peace? Well, that's different. Peace of what? Piece of pie? Piece of cake? Piece of pie cake? Also known as pake?
No, no, and no. You're thinking of peace as in P-I-E-C-E. I'm talking about peace, P-E-A-C-E. You know, peace, like the kind of peace in your heart that you get in hard times.
Well, shucks, I shouldn't know about that. Everybody does. We all go through hard times.
You're right, and it's terrible to go through those alone, but Jesus doesn't want that for us. Jesus wants to give us peace during those hard times. He wants us to know that he's in control and everything is going to be all right.
Boy. That sure is a good feeling to have. Better than any feeling mayonnaise, buckwheat, cream corn, and trout pizza could give you. It sure is good to know that Jesus is there for us.
Yes, it is. Jesus is always there, right by our side. And the boys and girls are going to learn that today. Well, at least they were. until we got interrupted.
Boy, I sure do hate it when people interrupt, don't you?
Yes, as a matter of fact,
Well, I might as well be heading out. I'll talk about pizza. All this talk about pizza is getting me hangry.
You mean hungry?
Nope, hangry. It's when you're so hungry, it makes you angry. This is Maple Sawback reminding you, don't eat wood unless you're a woodpecker. And if you are, wear a helmet. Bye-bye!
What's up, guys? Sid the Surfer here. I was just feeding my pet dolphin. His name is Ben. Yeah, I'm here to teach y'all today's awesome power verse. Today's power verse says, "And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid." John 14:27b. That was a gnarly power verse, but I need some help from all my rad dudes out there. So all the boys stand up and say it with me on the count of three. One, two, three. "And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid." John 14:27b. Awesome job, guys. You can all take a seat. Now I need some help from the girls out there. Stand up and say it with me on the count of three. One, two, three. "And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid." John 14:27b. Great job, guys. You can all have a seat. This power verse reminds me of a time where I was trying to nail this gnarly surf trick, but I kept on working on it and I couldn't get it down. I was scared and stressed out that I would never be able to get the trick down. But then I remembered that God gives us peace whenever we're troubled and afraid. So let's all say this power verse one more time. Everybody stand up and say it with me on the count of three. One, two, three. "And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid." John 14:27b. Awesome job, guys. You can all take a seat. Well, it's time for me to go catch some waves. I'm Sid the Surfer, and I'll catch you later.
Hey guys, today we're going to learn about how Jesus calms a storm. Today we're going to look at one of the coolest stories in the Bible. It's found in Matthew 8, verse 22 through 25. At this particular time, Jesus is doing what he loved to do. He was teaching people. It had been a long day, and Jesus really wanted to get away from the crowds. So he asked the disciples to push the boat out on to sea and to go to the other side so he could spend some time alone. So the disciples did just as Jesus asked. They set out on the Sea of Galilee. Everything seemed fine for quite a while. But suddenly, out of nowhere, a giant storm came upon the boat. The disciples started freaking out. The wind and the waves were tossing and turning the boat. Water was coming over the sides of the boat. The disciples were so afraid that they tried to keep the boat afloat during this storm. This whole entire time, however, Jesus was sound asleep in the boat. He wasn't even worried. The disciples went to Jesus and tried to wake him up. They said, "Master, Master, we are going to drown." They were afraid that the water was going to overtake the boat and cause the boat to sink. They really didn't want to die just yet. Jesus looked at the storm, he looked at the disciples, and he asked them a big question. He said, "Why are you afraid?" I'm sure the disciples were thinking in their minds, because I sure would have, "What do you mean, what are we afraid? Do you not see the storm?" Jesus definitely saw the storm, but he wasn't afraid. Jesus walked up to the front of the boat. He lifted his arms to the angry sea and said, "Peace, be still." And suddenly, immediately, the wind stopped. The rain stopped. The waves stopped. It was no longer a stormy sea. Instead, it was a calm and peaceful sea. The storm had stopped. Jesus turned to the disciples and asked, "Where is your faith?" Jesus was teaching them that they didn't need to run around being scared of the storm. They had forgotten the very person who has the power over the wind and the waves was right there in the boat with them. Instead of focusing on the storm, they should have been focused on the one who can bring calm and peace to the storm. In our lesson today, we're going to learn the same thing that the disciples learned on that day. Listen closely and learn that Jesus can bring peace to your life, even in the midst of a storm. So we're going to go into our lesson called, I Give You Peace. Who loves to get gifts? Do you love to get gifts? I love to get gifts. Sometimes you get them for your birthday, you get them for Christmas, you get them for housewarming gifts if your parents have ever gotten a new house, and sometimes people will bring gifts over. It's a wonderful thing to receive gifts. Did you know that Jesus came to give us an amazing gift? It's not a toy, it's not money, it's not even a new pony, which I would love to have a new pony. It's not something that you often think of as a gift from God. But it sure is. Do you want to know what it is? Jesus came to give us peace. P-E-A-C-E, peace. Peace is something we need more often than we think. Now, we are not talking about peace as in the ending of war. We're talking about peace in our mind and in our hearts. We often need peace because we all go through hard times. It doesn't matter who you are going to go through a hard time in life. Right now, we're kind of in the middle of a hard time. People hurt your feelings, friends move away. Sometimes, someone's going to pick on you. A member of your family might even get sick. It happens to all of us. Life is full of difficult moments that produce lots of stress and pressure in our lives. When hard times come, sorry, I gotta put this on here. There we go. When hard times come, the pressure builds. We start to feel very tense. We start to get upset. As problems come, stress comes. And if we try to handle things on our own, it ends up messing our lives pretty bad. Let's see if I can pump this up enough. I don't know that I can. Eventually, we're going to explode, right? It ends up messing our lives pretty badly. Our lives end up in pieces because the stress and the pressure has built and it was just too much for us to handle on our own. Jesus knew that the hard times would come to the disciples and to us. That's why he told them in John 14, verse 27, "I am leaving you with a gift, peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid." Isn't that amazing? Jesus didn't say, "I'm going to take away your stress." That would have been nice, but that's not what he said. He knows that stress and pressure are just a part of life. What he did say was that Jesus gives us peace during hard times. Rather than taking away every single trouble in our lives, Jesus says, "I will help you with the pressure. I will give you peace when the hard times come." But when sickness, sadness, loneliness, bullies, or any kind of pressure comes, you have to make a choice to give it to Jesus. If you give it to him, he will... It's going to squeal. He will give you release. He will give you release from that pressure and allow the peace to come back into your life. Isn't that awesome? Now, I know what you might be thinking. Well, Jesus told the disciples all of this right before he left them to go to heaven. He left them. How is he going to help bring peace to my life if he isn't even here on earth anymore? Well, the cool part is that Jesus, he may not be here on earth in a human flesh, but he sent the Holy Spirit back to earth. We can't see him and we can't touch him, but Jesus is always there. Peace comes when you remember that Jesus' Spirit is always with you. He is there to comfort you when you're sad. He's there to comfort you when you are lonely. He is there to comfort you when you're scared. You can't see him and you can't touch him, but he is always there. So no matter what happens, even if we can't see him, he's still there right with us. Now, if I had a friend here with me and they were standing in front of me, they wouldn't be able to see me, right? If they were facing you. But they would still know that I was there, right? They could still feel my presence. They would still know I was there behind them. That's kind of like how it is with God. We can't see him with our physical eyes, but we know he's there. We see the effect of him on us. We sense the peace that he brings, the joy that he brings. We see when we get healed, he brings that healing to us as well, okay? So, he can bring you peace when you remember that you are not alone. Jesus is always there. So we're going to bow our heads and close our eyes, and I'm going to pray over each one of you that you will allow God's peace to fill your hearts. If you're feeling anxious or scared or nervous or worried, I want you to release that to God. You see, I know we're in the middle of this pandemic. I know we're in the middle of uncertainty with everything changing on a daily basis. But the good thing is that Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He doesn't change. He doesn't leave us or forsake us. He stays right there with us. He sent the Holy Spirit to be a comforter, to be a presence with us, to walk through life with us. All right, so let's bow our heads and close our eyes. And just as I pray, I want you to release that to God. Release your stress, release your frustration, release your worry, and just allow that stress to be taken by God. Because God said that he would carry it. Jesus said his yoke, like an oxen yoke, they would put a yoke on the oxen, or they would pull a cart, and that weight was put on the oxen's shoulder. But God says that, or Jesus said that his yoke is easy and his burden is light. See, he takes that up off of your shoulders and he carries it for you. So let's bow our heads and close our eyes. Father God, we thank you for tonight and for learning about the peace that Jesus brought and that you give us. The gift of peace, that even when we go through hard times, even when we struggle, even when we have worries and we have stress and we have uncertainty and we don't know what's going to happen tomorrow, I thank you that you bring peace, that you know what's going to happen tomorrow, that you protect us, that you strengthen us, and that you walk with us daily. And Father God, I pray that right now, each home, as everyone is listening, I pray that you would just pour out peace upon them, Lord God, that you would bring peace to their minds, that you would help their minds to calm. Father God, that you would bring peace to their hearts, Father God, that you would take away the anxiety, take away the stress, take away the worry, Father God, and that you would replace it with your peace and your comfort, Father God. We thank you for what you're doing. We thank you for this time that we've had to come together to worship you. And Father God, I pray that you would help each one here tonight to remember that you are with them no matter what, that you are walking right next to them daily, and that you never leave them or forsake them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, guys, get ready for what's next.
Atmosphere is changing now, for the Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence. senses all around that the Spirit of the Lord is here. The atmosphere is changing now, for the Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all Spirit of the Lord is here. Overflow in this place. Fill our hearts with your love. Your love surrounds us. You're the reason we came.
What's up today? No matter what I'm going through, I can have peace. You can always have peace, or you have to work for peace. The answer is, no matter what I'm going through, I can have peace.
What came up on the boat while the disciples were at sea? A storm, a fish, or a snowman? The answer is, a storm.
Where was Jesus while the disciples battled the storm? Making a sandwich, asleep, or with the disciples? The answer is, asleep.
What happened when Jesus spoke peace to the storm? It stopped, he fell overboard, or it got worse? The answer is, it stopped.
In our video today, what happened to Tall Skinny? He was on vacation, he was kidnapped, or he was sick? He was kidnapped.
Who kidnapped Tall Skinny? His evil twin, his arch nemesis, or his nephew? The answer is his nephew.
According to our lesson today, we all go through what? Hard times, tough days, or silly moments? The answer is hard times.
According to our lesson today, Jesus gives us what during hard times? Candy, peace, or hope? The answer is peace.
According to our lesson today, blank is always there. The world, God, or Jesus? The answer is Jesus.
Where was our power verse found? John 14, 27, Mark 1, verse 8, or Leviticus 9, verse 12? The answer is John 14, verse 17.
All right, guys, we hope that you enjoyed your time with us tonight learning about the peace that only Jesus can give. Don't forget to get your videos in, so memorize your power verse. Send me those videos. You have until 7 o'clock p.m. on Friday night, and then we will actually do the drawing for Tiff's Treats on Sunday morning. So make sure that you do your power videos. Send them to me so that you can get in the drawing for Tiff's Treats on Sunday in person here at church. All right, guys, so let's bow our heads and close our eyes, and we're going to pray out. Father God, I thank you for this time that we have had to come together and to learn about the peace that Jesus gives, the peace that we don't understand, but that helps us go through our hard times. We thank you that you are with us, that you sent your Holy Spirit to constantly be with us, Lord, and that you never leave us alone. And Father God, I pray that you would remind each one watching tonight that you are with them even now, no matter what they're going through, no matter what they're facing, no matter what they might be afraid of. But Father God, that you would bring a peace right now into their home and into their hearts. Father God, we thank you for what you're doing. In Jesus' name, amen. Hey guys, don't forget, next week or this coming week, it's going to be on Sunday morning at the church. We have our 10:30 service and we have our 1 o'clock French African service. So come join us, get your videos in so that you can be in the drawing for Tiff's Treats this week.